Hi guys, welcome and welcome back to my channel. In today's recipe, I have this beautiful dessert for you guys. Today I am making this amazing strawberry crunch cake. Hopefully you enjoy it. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. Also like the video if you enjoy, and let's begin. Okay guys, I am using a cake mix to make this recipe to make it nice and easy. Like I told you guys, this was going to be super easy. So first thing I'll be doing is sift my cake mix flour. Now, I will have all the measurement below in the description box for you guys. Next, I am going to crack in 3 eggs. Just pour that in, as well as the oil. And also, I am pouring in the milk. Now, I'm going to be taking my hand mixer to mix it and make sure everything is well combined. Now I'm going to be taking a 9x9 round baking dish. I am going to pour half of the batter in here. But of course I am using parchment paper and a little bit of nonstick spray to make sure my cake come out easily once it's done baking. Now I'm going to set that aside, pour in the remaining of the batter in here. And also I am going to make another box of the cake mix. That way I can have about 4 layers of the strawberry cake. Now this is optional. I decided to use a white cake mix in the middle, so I am going to use half a box and basically repeat the same step that I just showed you guys in following the direction on the packaging. I am using half of the cake mix, like I said, and basically mix it together, and we're going to bake it according to the packaging. Now I'm going to pour it into this baking dish. This one is slightly bigger than the other ones, so I'm going to pour that in, and we're going to bake them on 350 for about 15 to 20 minutes. Once they're done, they should look something like this, very nice and golden brown, and we're going to place them onto a cooling rack. That way they can cool down. Now I'm getting ready to make my buttercream frosting. I am using about 2.5 cups of butter. Make sure it's nice and room temperature. That way you don't have to fight with it, okay? So I am going to use my hand mixer to mix that for about 5 minutes, okay? Once your 5 minutes is up, you are going to be adding in some powdered sugar. Just pour that in. Usually I don't like my icing to be too sweet, so I am going to add about 1.5 cup of powdered sugar. Now if you want, you can add more. Of course you have to taste it to see if you need more, but 1.5 cup is the sweet spot for me. Now I'm going to be adding in about a teaspoon of pure vanilla extract just to give it a nice flavor. We're going to stir it one more time or whisk or, you know, just mix it one more time until everything is well combined. Now I'm going to set that aside. Moving on, we're about to make our strawberry crunch crumble. I am using melted butter, vanilla wafers, as well as some jell-o to make this. Now I'm going to show you guys how I make the vanilla wafers into small pieces. I basically put them into a Ziploc bag and use a meat tenderizer to just mash them. And basically that's how I made it. So I am going to pour it into this bowl here. Next, I am going to add the jell-o, and then we're going to pour in the butter. We're going to mix that together. And if you want to take it the long way, you can make this with the flour and all, but like I said, this is an easy recipe. And yeah, since we're making this with vanilla wafers, you don't have to bake it. It's super easy. We're going to mix everything together. Once you are done, just pour it into a flat surface, let it air dry for about 10 minutes or 20 minutes until it's not wet anymore, and basically your strawberry crunch crumbles are ready. Okay, so now I am going to be assemble the cake. I am not cutting the cake. I should have cut it to make it nice and even. I didn't cut them, so don't come for me. But now I'm just gonna let you guys watch, because it's pretty self-explanatory just to watch. So keep watching. I'll show you guys what to do next. And like I said, I am not a professional. I don't make that much cake recipe on my channel. I should, but I don't. But let me tell you, if you're a beginner, you can definitely try this out. The way it came out, I was just like in shock, because it came out so good and so delicious, and the outcome is just wow. So I'm going to just cover the cake with the strawberry crumbled, I guess, just add them all over the cake just like that, and then we are going to be decorating it with the buttercream. I am going to add some strawberries on top just like that, just to make it nice and pretty. Now I'm going to be using a strawberry jelly. I will leave everything below, guys, just in case you're trying to make this at home. But I am going to add that to a squeezing bottle and just pour it all over. That's the best I can do. I mean, I think it's giving something, right? I think. So basically that is how I garnish my cake, I will say. And I place it in the fridge for about 30 to 40 minutes before I cut through it. And once I was done, I cut through my cake. It came out so beautiful. Oh my gosh. y'all, this is the recipe. I hope you guys give this a try. And if you do try this out for your family, don't forget to come back. Let me know your feedback. Let me know how you like it. Let me know how they felt about this cake. It came out very nice and pretty. You can make this for, you know, any type of occasion, even a birthday. Look how beautiful this came out. I love it. Don't forget to subscribe, guys. If you're new here, before you leave, hit the subscribe. Also, give me a big thumbs up because this recipe definitely deserves a thumbs up. It was super quick, super easy, and it came out very beautiful. I will see you guys soon. Bye.